Hello everyone, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we are going to learn how to compile and execute a Java program. To compile and execute a Java program, we will need to install a JDK file in our machine. Now let's understand what is JDK. Java Development Kit is a kit which provides the environment to develop and execute the Java program. Java Development Kit includes two things. First one is the JRE and second one is the development tools. Now, JRE having also some components like libraries, other files and JVM. Now, what is JRE? JRE refers to Java Runtime Environment. It is an installation package that provides environment to only run the Java program onto your machine. JRE only used by them who only wants to run the Java program. That is by the end users of your system, right? Now let's understand what is JVM. JVM refers to Java Virtual Machine. That is very important part of both JDK and JRE because it is contained, or we can say inbuilt in both. Whatever Java program you run using JRE or JDK goes into JVM, and JVM is responsible for executing the Java program line by line, hence due to which it is also called interpreter. Now let's understand how we can install the JDK setup. We will do nothing. We will just simply go to our browser and then just type JDK install. And you will get the first link, that is from the oracle.com. You just need to click it, then click on JDK download. Once you clicked it, you will land to another page, and here you will have to choose the setup according to your configuration, according to your operating system. Now in my case, I am having 64 bit configuration with Windows operating system. I am going to install this particular file. Once you install this, there are few methods through which you can check it out. Now see here, you will just here click to save and you will get the exe file, and you will need to do nothing, just install it simply. Now after installing that particular file, just go to the command prompt to check that whether the JDK file you installed is properly installed or not. To know that, what you will do, just type here Java hyphen version and press enter. Then you will get that on the front of screen, you will get that the version of Java. In my case, I am having 15.0.1. Now once you have checked it out, you are ready to go and compile and execute the Java program. Now let's go to the directory. I'm using here desktop, and I'm creating here a new file. Okay, now a new file would be of text document. Okay, now I'm writing here welcome. Make sure that the file name you are writing, the first letter must be capital. Okay, now with the help of this, here in the notepad we can write our program. Here I have written a very basic program, that is welcome to Java. It will basically print the string, that is welcome to Java. Okay, now let's save it. Once you have saved it, you will just need to go to the particular file, that is welcome.txt, and here you will need to rename it with java java. Now press enter. We have changed the extension of my file. Now we will go to the command prompt. Now what we are going to do with command prompt, let's see. First of all, we will jump to our desktop directory. Okay, yeah, To jump into your desktop, you will just need to write cd space desktop. After visiting the desktop directory, what we will do? We will do java c space the file name that we have saved in my desktop, that is welcome.java, right? Now after that you will just click enter. Once you have clicked enter, you will see that in the desktop folder, let me open it, you will see that in the desktop folder a new file generated automatically, and this is our bytecode. This is welcome.class. Now let's understand how we can run this particular file. It is welcome.class file that is going to run. Again, go to the command prompt and you will have to type few more line, that is java and welcome. See, here you do not need to write the extension, just simply write this and click enter. You will find that welcome.java has been printed. So we have learned how to run a Java and execute a Java program with the help of command line. Next we will understand how we can run a Java program with the help of an IDE. Now let's download an IDE. To download an IDE, we have to search in the browser. In my case, I am going to use Eclipse ID, so I am searching here Eclipse download and just click on the first link. After clicking on the first link, you will get the download option. Just click on it, then again click on it, and you will find that a downloadable file will be there. Once you download it, go to your download directly and click on your file. Once you click on your eclipse.exe file, you will get such an option. You will have to install Eclipse IDE for Java developers. Then just simply click here, install it, click next and next, accept all the things. Once you successfully install your IDE, just go to your Eclipse IDE, click on the file, and here is the new option. Just go to the Java project and give you any name. I'm giving here welcome. Okay, and just finish it. Here you just don't care, you can click on don't care. Just go to the welcome file, go to the source, right click on it, go to the new, and here you will need to click on class file. Now just give here class name. Here I am giving I am giving welcome, right? And you can also mark it here so that you will get a simple code. Just click on the finish and you will find that few codes already written by your IDE, and this is the beauty of using an IDE. Now we can simply write our code. Yeah, I am writing here welcome to geeks for geeks, right? It will print the string that is welcome to geeks for geeks. Now you will see that here it has printed, and you have seen that how IDE make us easy to write our code. Now let's learn how we can run or execute our Java program with the help of an online IDE. To do that, we will just need to type here geeks for geeks IDE. You will get the first link, just click on it, you will land the page, and here the code you can write. Here you can write your code, you do not need to install anything, just simply write it, click on the run. It may be quite slower than your installed IDE because this is dealing with online servers. Okay, once you have done this, you will find that your output has been printed. Hello Amrit, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. So in this video, we have learned what is JDK, how to install JDK, compile and execute Java program using command prompt, installing an IDE, we have used here Eclipse IDE, how we can compile and run a Java program using Geeks for Geeks online IDE without installing any setup. Okay viewers, thanks for watching this video. For more content, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.